What's up, everyone? Daddy Warbucks here, and today doing something a little bit different. We're going to not really be playing much of anything because I have some more DM stuff to do for these campaigns that I'm running through Roll20, and I really wanted to work on those today. So I figured throw up the stream. I'll work on these campaigns, and then anybody who's willing or interested can just kind of come, hang out. We'll talk about how the campaigns are going to progress. It's very possible that some of our players might be popping up and, you know, might be building some different characters and NPCs. And I don't know. I'm kind of winging it. I've never done anything like this before, so this is new. And, yep, that's it. That's the plan for today. So let me just look up. I'm gonna put on some music. So I shouldn't watch this. You can watch, because you might be able to see the map, but you're not going to be able to see what I put onto the map. That'll be something that I won't do until later. And honestly, like, even having the knowledge of what will come later, it's not going to save you, because things can always change depending on the number of players, the number of things and stuff, and I don't know. You're fine. Are your messages double posting? No. Why would they be double posting? All right. Give me a second to get situated. Because, like, right now, I'm not even going to work on your campaign. I'm going to work on this one. So this is the, make sure you're on the map, and align to Greg, three. Oh, that's right, I forgot about that thing that I do. They are on your ends, just making sure. Yeah, you're not double posting, you're fine, buddy. So I wanted to check to see if these guys had started. Nope, they haven't started their characters yet. I'll tell you what, I will post in the Facebook group for them. Here, I'll bring this over so that you can see what's going on. So there's that. We'll see if any of them show up and we can get that going. I'm not your buddy, guy. You shut your mouth. All right. One thing I did want to do for this game. No. You know what? I'm not going to mess with this yet. Simply because I'm not sure how many players there's actually going to be. So instead, let's work on this game that actually is involving that guy. Do I have my stream URL on a hotkey? No. We could always League of Legends. Are you off today? Why would you be off today? That doesn't make much sense. Let's call that 79. Oh. 82. That's a little better. Yeah, but why are you off today? That's what's not making sense. Alright, close enough. So there is that. Oof. And then I believe I did not. I need to do something about all these. Oh wait, I can, that's right, I can rearrange these. To the front. Square. They put you back on your old schedules. What? Why would they switch your schedule and then put you back? It makes no sense to me. I don't get it. Alright. So we need to zoom in to 150. And oh shit. Put it on the wrong layer. Boop. They wanted to see if it would help them more, but in the long run, my old schedule helped more. I don't know, corporate shit. That's stupid. So what, your schedule is not changing now? Like you're still gonna be same old thing? All right, click line to grid. Three, six, is that right? 28 by 24 pixels. You would think those are squares. Hold on, let me make sure I just didn't drag it out funky. Correct, Wednesday, 7 days on, 7 days off. Weirdo, that's just so weird. All right, advanced, align to grid. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. Guys running a game tonight? No. We are just, I have a lot of preparation to do for games. And I do my best to stream daily, and it's becoming increasingly difficult to have gameplay every day and still find time to prepare for campaigns. So we're doing an experiment. Stream is up. We're here, but we're just kind of talking and BSing about D&D. And while we do that, I am setting up for future campaigns. And hopefully a couple of my players from one of the other campaigns will pop in. So we'll be talking about doing some character creation, be building some NPCs and other things. And yeah, that's pretty much it. We're just farting around. Right now, though, I'm trying to figure out these. Grid cells are 28 by 25 pixels, but that's not right. I want to say it's 25 by 25. And let's align to the grid. And nope. No, that's pretty close, actually. That's pretty close. So let's zoom out. And I need to make this a lot bigger. Let's try hundo by hundo. That's way too big. And let's see. Oh no, that actually matches up really well. See, we're learning. Alright, so there's our map. Way too big. So let's scale that down to size just because. It'll bother me if I don't. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19, 20, 24, 26, 28. Let's try 30. Let's reduce it by 30. We're just guessing. 70. That's a pretty good guess. So 67. And then say by 10. By 10 more. This would probably go a lot quicker if I actually like measured. 3, 4, 5. Instead of just eyeballing it and doing the same process over and over. But there we go. There's our perfectly formatted map. Except it's not formatted. Now we have to set the lighting. So let's go back in. And we are going to enable the fog of war. Enable dynamic lighting and enforce line of sight. Only update on drop. Do I want to restrict movement? No, I don't. Alright. So now, what I've done is the whole map has went dark. And that kind of shows you where line of sight would be. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through. And we're going to draw on the map. And make sure that we are enforcing those lines of sight. So that as they move through, they won't see more of the map than they're supposed to. So, and it all starts here. We're just gonna kinda, that black line will obstruct any vision that goes through. And we're just going to very slowly and carefully trace along the edge. I could probably go faster, but no, I want quality. Oh no. Turn on some music. I can't just sit here in silence. I'll go crazy. Okay, come on, music. I know it's playing. It still is playing. It's just my headset hadn't picked it up yet. That's the problem with it being wireless, is sometimes it takes a second for it to receive the signal. Yes, ma'am.
New little picture thingy you can put on Facebook.
What?
It's a flower. Being your thankful. You can love something, wow something, haha something, you think?
Oh, a new emote?
Yeah, that's what I'm getting at. I just want to do the first four times.
That's stupid. What was I doing? Oh yes, making black lines. Also, Alex says hello.
Alex, no.
I don't know if you heard her, but she said you stink. Let's go ahead and there we are. I guess while we're here, no. What just happened? Oh, I went astray. Is what happened? Get rid of that. So. Line of sight obstructions over these pillars. They're not pillars, I think they're supposed to be boulders. Like inside the cave, there's stalactites that have fallen down. But as you're walking through the cave, they would obstruct your vision and line of sight. And provide cover, maybe. Why not? I'm good around these two too. It's like a figure eight. And let's go to the object and token screen, and I need something just to represent a source of light. Here we go, my little fire. So let's say it emits light in a 60-foot radius. And there we go. You see that it hits our barrier there and stops. And we can also see that when it hits our boulder, you know, it splits. Because obviously this area here is not illuminated. And if we were to move our fire around it. Alright, so far so good. Or if we go on the other side. Yeah, that's bad. But that's okay. We'll just hide that later. Okay. So far so good. Let's go ahead and we're gonna put our torch token over here for now. And go back to the dynamic lighting layer. What is going on here? Oh, I get it. It's a... No, my dynamic lighting's not going to be perfect, but I don't want to spend 6 hours on it either. Now let's, just to make sure, because I still have my doubts, we'll grab our fire. No, we won't. Grab our fire, and as we move through here, it's the only bad thing about these maps, is, you can clearly see there is something here. When walking through, it should be solid walls, and that's kind of showing that there's something under the ground. If I really cared, though, I'd Photoshop those out, but I'm not going to. So as they were to walk through, I haven't formatted any of those other sides yet. As they would walk through, it would come down this hall, and then it looks good. I mean, they can't see any of this in here. That's just gonna be solid rock anyway. Okay, let's stick our fire back at the entrance and go back to dynamic lighting layer. And now we're going to nothing because I didn't select my draw tool again. Flushing out the other side of the stairwell. I like this room. It's a nice big square. I want it. Yeah, you're on camera. Wave. This section here is a shelf that goes down. So it wouldn't obscure vision. Is that down or is that up? Now I'm confused. That's down. Here's the edge of the cliff. And then there's the slope. So that's all lower elevation. So then. You know, this makes me kind of wonder, right? Because this is just mindless, just going around and clicking on the border of everything. Makes me think about the D&D modules that you buy that already have the dynamic lighting already set. It just makes me think that they have some poor intern had to go through all the maps and to set the dynamic lighting for everything. spot. They go. All right. Which means this should be solid. Why is this one so bumpy? Oh, it goes two ways. Huh, this is a really neat map now I'm like looking at it. What? What do you mean? Wait, hold on. Okay. So this is all right, Junior Warbucks for anybody that may watch this in the future or is AFK just doesn't know. That's my son Lane. He's one of the players in our last campaign. He's Fife the Bard, and he just put this on the door. I'm buying you Volo's Guide to Monsters, and so now I want to ask, why are you buying me Volo's Guide? Like that's awesome, but you don't have to do that. You know, I'll get it eventually. Because Mother's Day is coming up. I'm not your mom. I mean, you could just wait until Father's Day next month. That would probably be more appropriate. Okay, good idea. If you have money, I'm sure your mom could help you out. Huh?
was cracking up laughing.
Why?
Because I put it from another day.
Yeah, I didn't even realize, like, I'm like, what does he mean, what's on the...
I went like this, and I'm looking at you watching, I thought you saw
something
in the
camera. Okay, what do you got?
Love you guys.
I love you too. Although, he walked out, so I don't know if he's still listening or not. I don't know if it's a good idea for my players to give me more monsters to throw at them. That seems like the opposite of what you want to do. I don't know if there's really stalagmites there, but I'm gonna add them in anyway, just because adds a little bit more flavor to the caverns as you're walking through. Have their vision obstructed. There's two right there. Okay, I kind of want to see about putting like these half. Nope, wrong. Did it again. One of these half little slits onto the steps. Just because then walking down the stairs, you would have these like, no, this just, it's not good. It's just funky. Lost my thought for a second. Here's my fire. Here. This one is down, obviously. I wish there was some way I could mess with the lighting, where like if they were standing up here, then it would be obviously darker down here because, you know, it's further away because of the elevation. But I don't think that there's any way that I could really do that and still have it make sense within Rule 20. I mean, other than just obstructing the view along this ledge, but then that doesn't make sense. Because standing up on this ledge, unless it's too far away for their vision, they should still be able to see. But then it would almost make it like, okay, you're standing on this ledge, and then walking down the stairs would reveal this area, at which point it would be like a new room. And I'm just not sure if that's how I want to do that.
Glad when this costume party is over and these creeps grow up and start to make a living like everybody else.
All right. Maybe if it is two separate things, like the ledge would be one encounter, maybe I will separate the vision. Okay, that's interesting. See, I can't in good conscience, like, just block the vision here, because that's supposed to be a 15-foot incline. So, standing here, and, you know, most of the races have a dark vision of 60 feet, they would clearly be able to see down there. But they are two separate. Well, it's... Yeah. Alright, we'll just leave it at that. I'm gonna go up here. Highlight these. Highlight. That's not highlighting. It's, go away, you.
What a gross little stage we dance on. What fun we have dancing, fucking, out of care in the world. Not knowing that we are not what was intended.
Okay, let's see. What does it say about this little thing? Because this, I think I actually will kill vision on one part, just because it looks like from here you climb up, at which point, you know, up over the ledge, they wouldn't be able to see. So I could cut the vision here, But then climbing up on the ledge, standing here looking down into this room, they would have vision, so then I wouldn't obstruct it on this side. Let me just read and make sure that I am interpreting that correctly. Oh no, nope, see I did not interpret that correctly. This isn't a climb up and then a drop down. This is two down. They said that's each ledge is 10, you know what, let's, because I will forget this if I don't. So we're going to go to the GM overlay where I can write myself little notes. And then text. So this is a 10-foot drop. Right there. 10-foot drop. 7. I can't even see that. That's ridiculous. Doo-doo. There it is. Let's make it 32. Red. And for drop. And for drop. And then here we said this is 15-foot drop. Nearly as noticeable as I had originally hoped. It was what, 32.5? Let's do it again. Except this time we'll go 56. Oh, that's better. And this, it can't be seen by anybody but me in game. So I can write notes all over it. And it's not going to affect anything. Foot drop, 10 foot. And let's rotate that. Not quite. Not quite. I guess that's the best it's gonna get. Okay. How much is that in there? Well, you know what? I might as well, while I'm working on the GM layer, this that's area 1, 2 I'm Dukes. Seven. Let's relocate some of those. About where it should be. One, two, three. Okay. Seven. There's our torch. Eight. And these numbers that I'm writing down now, these are just so that, because this isn't a pre-made module, like I had to import everything and format it all myself. This is so that I can reference those locations in my book whenever we get to that point. 13, center. This is 10A. 10. 10B. Fancy. Five. Hey, my phone's on charge. Yeah. This is an area too. Oh, okay. That's a good thing to know. On the DM info overlay, let's draw a shape. And that color. What could that shape mean? I don't know. Alright. Your friend Tyrul has started watching. Well, hi there, Tyrul. How are you doing? Floor drops down. I already did that. Seven. 10-foot drop-off, so we need to text 10-foot drop. Put that there. No such thing as lurking anymore. I know, right? Yeah. It's kind of good, kind of bad. Well, there is, but we're friends on Twitch. So it tells me whenever you come into the channel. Alright, let's go back to the objects and tokens. I'm gonna move this around. Now that would not be seen. None of these marks would be seen by the players. They're on the GM overlay. So even like this here, the indication of the thing. No, it is not to rule. This is I can show you. This is, let's go here. We'll use that link is probably easiest. This is Horde of the Dragon Queen I'm working on currently. you are in Lost Mine of Phandelver and potentially Sunless Citadel. So, yeah, you could totally hang out right now. Although I'm still somewhat limited in how much I can say because oh, he left. Okay, I can totally say it. One of the players was watching, and I didn't want him to know that this is a trap. Dirty Leprechaun, how are you doing? Welcome to the stream. All right, so I got all my. Oh no, I don't have everything marked yet. Sturges. I'll make sure. Right here. And number six. There's number six. There's number six. You got to run this adventure with new players in real life? Ah, me too! See, I bought the books quite some time ago and then it never happened in real life. So now I'm trying to take it all and put it into Roll 20 and I don't know, it's a lot of fun. We did the attacks in Greenest about 2 weeks ago, and that was a lot of fun. I was kind of surprised when my bard managed to convince Lenathan to stop attacking by playing his lute. That was quite exciting. So six, let me check. Turn across inches and give it a shrimp. So what curtain? What is it talking about? Who's this curtain? Oh, okay. So we need to draw that on the map and background layer. And we're just gonna. Hey, that's not the tool I was looking for. Oh, no. Objects and tokens? Is that where I was? Where was I mapping background? Select. Son of a bitch. What did I do? I need to grab that line, it won't let me! Objects? That just might be a new permanent fixture of the map. There we go. Clear drawings? Oh, no. That's bad. Well, yeah. We're just gonna finish the job now. Yeah, right there. That's totes what it's supposed to look like. Alright, I don't really care. So that is on the map on background. Let's go back to the GM overlay. We're going to. No. What's your party look like for your in real life campaign? So there's that. Thank you. Okay. So we have another one here. And we're just going to place it right there. Possibly an elven cleric. I'm thinking another will play a druid, and then another will play a rogue. Oh, so you actually haven't started yet. Well, I would strongly advise you, okay, that you pressure the cleric and the druid, if he does take druid, make sure that they have healing magic. Because the first encounter, the Siege of Greenest, it's rough. Like, I had a party of four, and they barely made it through it. At one point, they were knocked out, which was kind of supposed to happen. But it's a very long encounter with no opportunities for rest. And that's kind of how it's designed. Like, they're supposed to feel, like, fatigued and overworked as they're trying to survive this night and this siege. But... yeah, it just make sure that you let them know, or even if you don't want to give them that knowledge beforehand, make sure you have some plans in place. The what if they get their asses kicked, because it will happen. Like, you know, I made sure to sprinkle some extra potions like in the sanctuary, and then I had like. At one point, reinforcements are supposed to come help them in the encounter at the mill, and the reinforcements are supposed to be like three guards, but then I had like one of them be an acolyte from the sanctuary and come and assist with healing. But yeah, I'm pretty sure they're gonna end up dying too, but for a level one encounter, it's brutal. Like, it's but it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun when at the end of it all, I mean, my party was cheering and, like, everybody had a really good time. I used to DM 2nd edition Menzo Brazen and Mithranor and Forgotten Realms. Right on. Between area 4 and 7. Top step. Okay. I'm liking this dungeon already. I mean, look at this. That is just sadistic. Like, la, 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 la. Oh man, there's a trap, and then you keep walking and like, oh, we just survived the trap, there surely can't be another one right there. Okay. 9 8 9. Currently playing a 3.5 Apocalypse Eberron game. That's cool. Like, I played very little of 3.5, but I don't know. I like 5th edition a lot better just because of how simple it is, how they reworked everything to be a lot safer for, you know, for the everyman. 3.5 is just chaotic with all the different options and optional rules. I should say, not options. You're eaten by a dire bear. Well, that can't be good. Small one chest. sits on the floor in the corner. Thaco. Yeah, oh god. You know, I was very young during First and Second Ed, but I remember Thaco. And I remember trying to understand it, and then it's like... Northwest corner. Okay, northwest corner of the room. So we're going to put it right here. And let's put that there. And then I want to make a note. Okay, I think that's it for the markings. I don't think I ever finished the dynamic lighting. Let me check here. Nope. Like online. Whoa. So hard. Oh, it looks like I was almost done with the dynamic lighting. Couple things I wanted to get ready with. Nope. Here from top, ceiling quickly lowers. Now, I don't think. Is that something that I added, maybe? No, it's something I have to add. Okay, so let's, I think I have it open on another tab. Now there are, you know, there's certain enemies and NPCs that are in the, you know, the Horde of the Dragon book that are not available in the Monster Manual, and it, for those cases, I have to, you know, take their stat block and add it into Roll 20, and then assign it a token and all that fun stuff. So right now, we're at the point where they reference the Dragon Claw, which is a special type of cultist. And I thought I had done... Oh, yeah, I did. I did do it already. There's our Dragon Claw. You see, I already took it and typed it all in. All right, then. So I'm going to pop that out. Move it off screen over here where I can still look at it and reference it. All right. So, first of all... What layer am I on? I'm on the GM layer this time, right? Get rid of our fire. Enters the cave, is brought in tall, sailing quickly lowers, standing guard at the entrance. Two dragon claws. So they're gonna be about there. No, we're gonna move them back. We're gonna move them back so they're not immediately seen. And, what is that black dot? Is that on my screen? It is. It's a fleck of paint. Alright. Two dragon claws guard the entrance. And fungi. Of course they're not already in the compendium. Alright. So now we need to pull our handy dandy thingy. Violet fungi. They'll be at the bottom of the PDF. This thing that I have right here, if you're going to be doing Tyranny of Dragons, might want to look it up. It's in from the DM's Guild. It's a free resource, but it's a PDF, and it has all the NPC and monster stats straight from the book. That and the idea is you're supposed to print them off, and then you have them for easy reference, and then you can always just mark what your initiative and current hit points is. But me, I'm just using them so that they're here in my computer where I can reference them. And where is this violet fungus? There we go. And, oh, I grabbed the wrong page. So let's move that over there. What? I did it again. This over there. So. And let's find violet fungus images. Oh, we got some good ones. Now I'm kind of feeling this guy right here, because that looks pretty neat. What is that? That's a fungus goblin. That is not what we're looking for. This one could be cool. That looks like crafting on roll 20. Yeah. Yep, because this isn't, okay. I bought the monster manual, you know, module for roll 20. So any monster that's available in the monster manual, you know, I have them all here, and I can just click on them, and they're already, you know, statted, and I can just, like, drag and drop them onto the field, and then I would have, like, their character sheet and everything ready. But for creatures that are specific to a campaign, in this case, our violet fungus, I have to create a token for it, add a character sheet, and then add in all that information manually. So, right now, do I want to go with this, or do I want to go with something like this? I'm thinking this. I mean, this looks like art straight from the monster manual. Plus, it's got a cool little skull. So let's, we're gonna save that image. Save. too many things open. Actually, I should check and see if I already have one here. I'm not even in the right area. That's a cool unicorn token. Joke. Hey, look, there is one right there. It's not the one I wanted to use, but for the sake of laziness, we'll take it. So let's upload. Desktop D&D tokens with an exclamation point. Violet fungus. That's good. That's how I had to do it before they got Wizard of the Coast permission. Pinterest is totally my friend, right? Alright, so there's our violet fungus. Let's get to the fun part. And by fun, I mean awful. Character. Violet fungus. Just me. And... oh my god, we just did this! Character sheet. NPC. Okay. So let's pull up my NPC stats. And it's going to be off screen, but I'm just literally typing it in as it says. Violet, fungus, NPC type, medium plant on the line. AC 5, hit points 18, 4d8, speed 5. Wow, they suck. Alright, 3, 1, 10, 1. 3, 1, 10, 1. So these things are not meant to be challenged. I haven't even actually, like, looked at these creatures yet. I have no idea what they're supposed to be. They have no saves? Alright. Cannon fodder, right? Senses? No languages? Damage vulnerabilities? Immunities? Blinded, definitely frightened. Senses, blind sight 30 feet. And out. I mean, it seems like common sense, but I'm gonna type it in anyway because languages. NA, can't talk. Challenge. /4. 50 XP. It's not a spell attacking NPC. does not have reactions. Toggle. Hey, that's exactly it. False appearance. I wonder if I just don't type anything. While the violet fungus remains motionless, it is indistinguishable. Did I spell that right? Google says yes. From an ordinary fungus. I had to read that twice. I was like, there's no way. The fungus makes 1d4 rotting touch. Come on now. Attacks. Well, that seems pretty interesting. What is a rotting touch? Is an attack. Melee. Reach of 10 feet. Well, hey, you. Two hit. That's plus two. And it is one target. 1d8. And that looks like it. Okay. Watching old school NPC entry, the pain of hours doing this still remains. I know, man. I know. That's why I bought the monster manual. Like, it saves just so much time and preparation. But then you still have to, you know, go back and put them in manual. Okay, so there's our violet. Let's move him in with the other enemies. So there's our violet fungus. And edit. And then we are going to stat this token. Oh, shit. I just closed it. Stat this token. 18. 5. Don't need to set up a vision radius because it won't matter. Actually, it does kind of matter, doesn't it? No, I see everything. Blah, 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 blah. You select the token, save changes. Okay. Now we can delete that. And where the heck did those go? Hey, thanks for the cheer, buddy. Appreciate it. Gonna have to cheer a lot more though for it to. I don't think I can actually earn any money from Cheers until it's at like 10,000. Okay, so we get 4 of these suckers. Remember the cheese got... It, like, melted because of the disgorgement from the, Am I in the GM layer? No, I'm on the token layer. All right, cool. That's where I want it to be. It says that there are this whole thing is like covered in fungus, so we're just gonna populate it with all kinds of tokens. Did you miss an adventure in between? Thinking so, since Switch has been a luxury of time as of late. No, you have not. If at the top of the stream and all the tabs up there, one says events, all of the D&D streams are scheduled well in advance. The next one is this Saturday, which will be where we continue our Horde of the Dragon Queen. And then next Saturday is part 4 or 5 of Lost Mines of Phandelver. And then the Saturday following that is going to be a new group starting the... I forgot the name. Sunless Citadel. No. I'm wrong. Not this Saturday. Saturday after next. The 20th. Yes. The 20th is Horde of the Dragon Queen. 27th is Lost Mines of Phandelver. And then the 3rd is Sunless Citadel. Once again, if you click that link at the top, all of those are scheduled. I just said the wrong thing. Oh, shoot. Where can that be? That one. Delete the remote. Alright. That's... Alright. Now we're in the map and background layer. Some more fungus. This is in the map background layer, so this is just for, this is just for show. Lots on the DM plate, don't know how I juggle it. You know, just like this. And as long as I have, enough time in advance to plan and schedule, I can make it work. Because, especially with Roll 20, and... Lost Mines of Phandelver is a Roll 20 module, so everything is already set up for me. I just have to make sure that the players are on board, and that if there's anything else that I am adding to the campaign to make it unique, I have to make sure that stuff is set up. So most of it's done. Same thing with the Sunless Citadel. Sunless Citadel is another Roll20 module, so there, that's that. Horde of the Dragon Queen, like, I have to do all of this from scratch. So this is the one that's taking the most time to prepare, and this is the one that's getting the most of my attention. That's why, I don't know if any of you have noticed, but underneath the stream, I added an additional panel that is specific to our D&D streams, and that panel sets up like a tier system for rewards that you can buy as far as the D&D streams go, ways you can interact and stuff like that. And the reason I did that is because, you know, I like to use all of my streams throughout the year as an opportunity to raise money for charity. But with D&D, I kind of want to bring some of that into the stream, because Roll20 has a monthly sub and these modules are $50 a pop. And I think of all the things I do on the stream, D&D is my favorite. And I want to focus on bringing this kind of content more often, but with only so many with only so many mods at my disposal, there's not a whole lot I can do. So I want to try and raise money to buy like the Storm King's Thunder mod. And do I think they're useful? I think that they're wonderful, man. Like there's a couple things that I wish were a little bit different. Like, on the Elmot module, some of the dynamic lighting is a little off, but it's still workable. Like, it's all, you know, like, where it should be. And I think it's well worth the money. Just because of sheer, just alone, the amount of time it saves me with preparation. And then, since I'm using, you know, my stream, you know, to role play with a lot of different groups, I can take that Lost Mines of Phandelver module, and I can have two or three different groups all playing Elmop. You know, it's as simple as, all right, find the players. Here's the module. I just set it to run, and everything is already prepared. And I don't know, for the fact that I'm trying to include more and more D&D in my stream rotation, the modules are invaluable. Maybe if you're only going to play it once or twice, I don't know if it'd be worth it then. But it's even to the point now where, given the option of buying material, if it's available on Roll20, instead of I'll buy it there before I buy it in a book version. Like through the Yawning Portal, you know, most everything else I own a physical copy of. Like, I own a physical copy of Horde of the Dragon Queen. I own a physical copy of Dungeon Master's Guide, Player's Handbook, all that stuff. But through the Yawning Portal, I bought only on Roll20 because of the modules and all the extra bells and whistles, and it's been a lot of fun. End grant. Okay, what was I doing? No, room 4. Funguses for decorations. To the GM info. Yeah. 1, 2. Okay. This one, he's in Horde of the Dragon Queen. Means he shouldn't really be getting a peek behind the curtain, but without actually going into detail and you know, knowing what all of this shit means, he's still gonna be stuck. Well, he wouldn't know her as Shelby the Wizard. When he hung out with us last time, it was during, it was during Greenest. It was the first of this. So he would know her as Bridget. Damn you, bot. I must follow your commands. Do it. Do it. Seven. Yep, she actually, I'm in the game. Bridget, character sheet. I see it right here. Yep, it's still one. Why does it say one? Bam. Nat 20 on next roll. Okay, so we got should be something like an int check. Yeah. Why do you need me to show you your sheet? You can get in the game and see your sheet. He actually got pretty decent rolls now I'm looking at him. You just want everyone to see you. There's you. Even though Lane is pretty convinced that you're a lady. I made it already. No. Serious? Alright, well, looks like I gotta type up another NPC. Import? Well, I can't just import an NPC. I still have to... I got some Chris $1 for you. Content Diablo. That's an old video too. Like, why is that? Right. Dude. Where am I at here? Oh yeah, I'm procrastinating. That's what I'm doing. Alright, let me get to... Although, you know what? I'm probably... doing it again. Tokens? Nope. Tokens? That's the one from the monster manual, so this one is. I want that one. Although, I don't want the text. Oh, that's a good one. Save image. Manager at a bookstore. Hey, no shame in there. Let's go red? Why not red? Solid background. File. Save token. Close. Close. And then... And I swear I did... Oh no, that was the ambush trick that I did. Completely different thing. I didn't know that. You used to LARP? Most fun you ever had? Alright, here we go. Fun times now. That's called something else. I'm pretty sure you're making that up. Don't you lie to me. Okay. I'll do it your way, robot. Enough distractions. Skill preserver. Does not belong here. Or there. Bite. Weapon attack. Plus 5 to hit. Reach 5 feet. One target. 1d8. Plus M? No, plus 3. Piercing. Say plus 0. Nah, I didn't want to roll it. 5. 5. No, yeah, you can request songs, Firebeard. I mean, it costs bucks, but you get bucks just for hanging out in chat, following the stream. So you should already have, quite a bit saved up. Just hit exclamation bucks and it'll tell you how many you have. Right. B-U-X. Not B-U-C-K. You know, because my name is Daddy War. B-U-X. Bucks. Bucks. Money. I'm gonna shut up.
Is this the book?
Yeah. Why? Is he really gonna buy it?
Yeah, he said he wants to do it for you.
Well then, wait.
What?
How much is it there?
30.
Okay, just do that.
Why? Where'd you see it cheaper?
It's not cheaper. No. What's that noise? No shit, the sink on. Bite? Tail. What am I getting? Yo, you missed it. Earlier in the stream, right? Okay. So I'm sitting here, blah, 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 typing away. And then my son Lane jumps into Twitch chat. And his Twitch name is Junior Warbucks because he's so clever and I love it. Anyway, but he says in Twitch chat, look on the door behind you. And I turn and I look. And there was a note. So I go and I get the note and I bring it up to the stream and I show it and read it. And it says, I'm going to buy you Volo's Guide to Monsters. And it's like, you know, that's just so amazing. Because, you know, he has money that he's, you know, just kind of saved up and has kept. And, you know, the kid doesn't want to buy anything for himself, really. Like, he tried to buy something for his mom the other day. Now he's going to buy me this book. And it's like, you know, he's so generous. Ha! Your son loves you! Ha ha ha! Bet you feel dumb. Oh, this is a good song. One day mine will get me something nice instead of poop in them pants. No, your kids will be, you know, 14, 15, and be like, I made a poopy. Here you go. Has anyone watched season 2 of Attack on Titan yet? I have not. So if you spoil something for me, I'll murder you. I would, but it's not available anywhere I can see it. I mean, and I don't think... Okay, that's not true. I know it's on... is it on Crunchyroll? Okay, here's the problem, though, okay? Is, you know, I have my anime collection, right? And the collection is all complete series. Like, we generally don't watch an anime that is still ongoing because we'd like to own the whole thing and add it to like a part of the collection. And you know, we got into Attack on Titan because of all the hype, and we've been waiting so long for a second season. And yes, we can go and watch the second season, but we won't own it. So like, I probably wouldn't even consider getting Attack on Titan Season 2 until it's out for purchase, and then it'll be a part of the collection, and then me and the wife can binge watch it in like a week. You know what I mean? Attack on Titan Season 2? Oh, yeah. I was confused because we were talking anime, and then... Alright, I think that's it for the thing. Let's go ahead and plop that down. AC 1452, so... 52. 14. You select a token. And now every time I drop this, should be, yep, formatted, like a smart person. Oh, no, I don't disagree with you there. Cowboy Bebop is amazing. That's part of the collection. Normal stats of Gertrude. I don't have cable. I've never watched it. Played the R&M app like Pokemon Go. That's how you're talking to me. Are you talking about this here? That's because I needed to illustrate something on the map. And that's my awesome drawing skills. As far as the X, don't you worry about that. That's a secret. Two secrets about me? There. I smell. No, sir. You smell. Okay. Wrong layer. Actually, I think that's it. At least for now. No, it's not.
I think it's time to blow this scene. Get everybody in the stuff together.
Did I ever? I did.
3, 2.
I am smart. This token. All right. I recognize this song. So, what time is it? 10:30. Well, that's gonna have to be it then, because I have to work in the morning. So, on that note, let's go ahead and close it out, boys. If you enjoyed the stream, make sure you hit that follow button. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Leave a like on the video too. Also, make sure you go underneath the stream and follow me on Twitter or Facebook. That way you can get notifications on stream events and giveaways. And hopefully you guys had as much fun as I did. And if you did, I'll see you tomorrow.